The moon was a ghostly galleon, tossed upon the cloudy seas. The road was a ribbon of moonlight over the purple moon. And the highwayman came riding, riding, riding. The highwayman came riding up to the yielding door. He had a French cocked hat on his forehead, a bunch of lace on his chin, a coat of claret velvet, and breeches of brown doe skin. His feet were never a wrinkle, his boots were up to the thigh, and he rode with a jewel twinkle, his pistol buds a twinkle, his rapier hilt a twinkle under the chill sky. And all the cobbles he clattered and clashed in the darkened yard, and he tapped with his whip on the shutters, the ball was locked and barred. He whistled a tune to the window, and who should be waiting there? The landlord's black-eyed daughter, past the landlord's daughter, plaiting a dark red love knot into her long black hair. One kiss, my bonny sweetheart, I'm after a prize tonight, but I shall be back with the yellow gold before the morning light. If he'd press me sharply and hurry me through the day, then look for me by the moonlight, watch for me by the moonlight, I'll come to thee by the moonlight, though hell should bar the way. He rose upright in his stirrups, he scarce could reach a hand, but she loosened her hair in the casement, his face burned like a brand, as a black cascade of perfume came tumbling over his breast. And he kissed its waves in the moonlight, oh, sweet waves in the moonlight. He tugged at his rein in the moonlight and galloped away to the west. Gypsy's ribbon looping the purple moon. A redcoat troop came marching, marching, marching. King George's men came marching up to the yielding door. They said no word to the landlord, they drank his ale instead, but they gagged his daughter and bound her to the foot of her narrow bed. Two of them knelt at the casement with muskets at the side. There was death at every window, hell at one dark window, for Bess could see through the casement the road that he would ride. They had tied her up to attention with many a sniggering jest. They had bound a musket beside her with a bow beneath the breast. Now keep good watch, and they kissed her. She heard the dead man say, look for me by the moonlight, watch for me by the moonlight, I'll come to thee by the moonlight, though hell should bar the way. She twisted her hands behind her, but all the knots held her. She writhed her hands to her fingers, were wet with sweat and blood. They stretched and strained in the darkness, and the hours crawled by like years. To now, when the stroke of midnight called on the stroke of midnight, the tip of her finger touched it, the trigger at least was hers. Thank you. out, have you heard it? The horses' hooves ring clear. Toddle-la, toddle-la, in the distance, where they daft, they did not hear. Down the ribbon of moonlight, over the brow of the hill, the highwayman came riding, riding, riding. The redcoats looked to the priming, she stood up straight and still. Toddle-la to the frosty silence, toddle-la to the echoing night. Nearer came and nearer, her face was like a light. Her eyes grew wide for a moment, she drew a lasty breath. Then her finger moved in the moonlight, her musket shot at the moonlight. Shattered her breast in the moonlight, and wound him with her death. He turned his spur to the west, he did not know she stood. But with her head of a musket, drenched with her own red blood. Not till the dawn he heard it, his face could play to hear.